Hello everyone, this is Dan Pitts hunting for our guys today. We're going to be reading Job 21 from the Nyarlathotep version, also known as the NIV version. If you guys want to go ahead and read along, you guys can go to classpublic.com, or you guys can go ahead and go to your Bible. You guys can do whatever you guys want, I don't really care. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started. Job 21, Nyarlathotep version, NIV, Job. Then Job replied, "Listen carefully to my words. Let this be the consolation you give me. Bear with me while I speak, and after I have spoken, mock on. Is my complaint directed to a human being? Why should I not be impatient? Look at me and be appalled. Clap your hand over your mouth when I think about this. I am terrified. Trembling seizes my body. Why do the wicked live on, growing old and increasing in power? They see their children established around them, their offspring before their eyes. Their homes are safe and free from fear. The rod of God is not on them. Their bulls never fail to breed. Their cows calve and do not miscarry. They send forth their children as a flock. Their little ones dance about. They sing to the music of timbrel and lyre. They make merry to the sound of the pipe. They spend their years in prosperity and go down to the grave in peace. Yet they say to God, 'Leave us alone. We have no desire to know your ways. Who is Almighty that we should serve him? What would we gain by praying to him?' But their prosperity is not in their own hands. So they stand aloof from the plans of the wicked. Yet how often is the lamp of the wicked snuffed out? How often does calamity come upon them, the fate God allows in his anger? How often are they like straw before the wind, like chaff swept away by a gale? It is said God stores up the punishment of the wicked for their children. Let them repay the wicked so that they themselves will experience it. Let their own eyes see their destruction. Let them drink the cup of the wrath of the Almighty. For what do they care about the families they leave behind when their allotted mouths come to an end? Can anyone teach knowledge to God since he judges even the highest? One person dies in full vigor, completely secure and at ease, well-nourished in body, bones rich of marrow. Another dies in bitterness of soul, never having enjoyed anything good. Side by side, they lie in the dust, and worms cover them both. I know full well what you are thinking, the schemes by which you would wrong me. You say, 'Where now is the house of the great, the tents where the wicked lived?' Have you never questioned those who travel? Have you paid no regard to their accounts, that the wicked are spared from the day of calamity, that they are delivered from the day of wrath? Who denounces their conduct to their face? Who repays them for what they have done? They are carried to the grave, and watch is kept over their tombs. The soul in the valley is sweet to them. Everyone follows after them, and a countless throng goes before them. So how can you console me with your nonsense? Nothing is left of your answers but falsehood." If you guys enjoyed, make sure to subscribe, make sure to click the like button, make sure to click the bell so you're notified when I post. I hope that you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye!